إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة لعلكم تشكرون. And Allah has brought you out from the wombs of your mothers while you know nothing. And he gave you hearing, sight, and hearts that you might give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created our body. And Allah gave us different organs. And they are not the same. I mean in importance. The main one is the heart. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةٍ. In the heart there is a piece of flesh. إِذَا صَلُحَتْ, if it is sound, then the whole body will be healthy. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ, فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. And if it is ill, if it is corrupt, then the whole body will be corrupted. Al-qalb. We don't mean when we talk about the heart. In the hospital, we need to take care about the heart, the cholesterol, the hypertension. This is not our topic. Allah talks in the Quran and in the Sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about the heart and the diseases of the heart. Al-ghafla, heedlessness. Al-hasad, the envy. Al-ghil wal-karahiyya, hatred. Very dangerous diseases. We should know what are the diseases, what are the symptoms, and how to treat these diseases. Some of the ayat and the hadith in the Quran about the heart and the heart problems and the importance also of the heart. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. Verily therein is indeed a reminder for him who has a heart. Everyone has a heart. Without heart, you cannot live. But it means you have a good, a sound heart that is working, can hear, can understand, can act upon the verses of the Quran and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the scholars mentioned that heart diseases are two types. Marad الشبهات ومرض الشهوات. Diseases relate to the doubts, and the second, the desires and lust. Marad shubha, doubt. Is it true that there is hereafter, there is paradise, hellfire after the death? Or this is not true? You are not sure. The disease of hypocrisy. They will support, I mean the hypocrites support the one who is stronger. Who is stronger? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or Abu Jahl? Subhanallah, you are not sure about your religion? They live with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. They fight with him, they pray, they give charity. But they have a problem inside. They are not sure. Are you sure about your religion? Do you believe in Allah? Do you believe in the angels? Do you believe there is punishment in the grave for those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? After the death, people will be in paradise or the hellfire. Do you believe in these things? Do you believe in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the messengers of Allah, the qadr, the destiny? This is related to the doubts. Are you sure or have doubts in your religion? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, temptations will be presented to men's hearts as reed mat is woven stick by stick. Sin after sin. Calamity after calamity. Lust after lust, desire after desire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing you. How can we estimate this is a good student and this is a C student, A student? By the test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing his slaves. By shubuhat wa shahawat. Stick by stick. And any heart which is impregnated by them will have a black mark put into it. If you absorb, if you accept the sin, there will be a black dot in your heart. The next sin will be easier. Why? Because you accepted the first one. The second, the third, until the heart fully is black. لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا. Subhanallah. Sin after sin, because of accepting the sins. Because of not resisting the sins. The believer should resist. No, this is haram. I will not accept this. A'udhu billah, this is riba. This is interest. Not allowed in Islam. This is adultery. Not allowed in Islam. Bribe. Stealing. This is the heart of the believer. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who is accepting. So if you accept every sin, then there will be a black dot. The second one, but any heart which rejects them will have a white mark put in it, the heart. The result, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is that there will become two types of hearts, one white like a white stone, which will not be harmed by any temptation. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala noticed that you are rejecting, resisting the sins, Allah will support you. Allah will help you. Allah will protect your heart. Abyad, white stone. What is the meaning of the color white? If there is any dirt, it will be clear to and easy to clean it. So long as the heavens and the earth endure. Forever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect this heart. And the other black and dust colored like a vessel which is upset. If you put a cup on the opposite, upright, then you try to pour the water, the juice, the tea. This cup will not accept any kind of drink. It will not accept any kind of advice. It will not accept any hadith, any ayah from the Quran or Sunnah. Not recognizing what is good or rejecting what is wrong. And bad sin. Because of what? Because of the sins, temptations. He accepted them. And the heart now is black. The worst disease, The disease of kufr, a'udhu billah, with nifaq, the worst disease. I mean the disease of the heart. Al-kufr, wal-nifaq, wal-shak, hypocrisy, disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are in doubt, as I mentioned, in the angels. Do we believe in the angels? Yes, we believe in the angels. I have doubt. A'udhu billah. This is not Islam. We believe that Jibreel came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was in the cave of Hira, Jabal al-Nur, the mountain of Nur. Jibreel came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was with his friends, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Many times the angel Jibreel, visit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, Musa, Isa, all the prophets. We believe in Jibreel. This is one of the principles in Islam. I have doubt, then this is not Islam. This is the worst, the most dangerous disease. If you reject anything from Islam, kufr wa nifaq, fi qulubihim marad, fazadahumullahu marada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. In their hearts is a disease. And Allah has increased their disease. A painful torment is theirs. Because they used to tell lies. Because they did not accept the haq. They rejected the truth. They fought the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They accused the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They tried to fight Islam and Muslims. They are anti-Islam. That's why Allah punished them by locking the hearts of the kuffar. So it is sealed. It is not accepting anything haq, any truth anymore. Another kind of disease, marad al-ghafla, heedlessness. He's busy. He's running to earn the money. I need money. I need to ensure the future of my children, my family. He's busy day and night. Please, brother, come to the salah. I am busy. I will pray later, inshallah. At the end of the day, he is very tired. He missed all the salah. He's traveling from one place to another place. And if you tell him about the 5 minutes to pray, he's busy. Ghafla. We need some charity for our brothers in this country or any country. I don't have money. He has a lot of money. He has two houses. One house here, one house there. But only he thinks about the dunya. Busy, busy, all the time busy. Ghafla. Until the death comes. And the death will not knock the door. Death will not take permission from you. People die suddenly. The angel of death, Malakul Maut, will not ask you the permission to take your soul. Are you ready for this moment or not? Al-ghafla. Iqtaraba lin-nasi hisabuhum wa hum fi ghaflatin mu'ridun ma ya'tihim min dhikrin min rabbihim muhdath illa istama'uhu wa hum yal'abun lahiyatan qulubuhum wa asarru an-najwa alladhina zalamu هل هذا إلا بشر مثلكم أفتأتون السحر وأنتم تبصرون. Allah says, draws near for mankind, their reckoning, the day of judgment, the hereafter, while they turn away in heedlessness. ما يأتيهم من ذكر من ربهم محدث, comes not unto them an admonition from their Lord as a recent revelation, but they listen to it while they play. They enjoy the life. Busy in the life. لَاهِيَةً قُلُوبُهُمْ, with their hearts occupied with evil things, those who do wrong. They are heedless. The death comes without permission. One of the diseases, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, the disease of the desire diseases, يا نساء النبي لستن كأحد من النساء، إن اتقيتن فلا تخضعن بالقول فيطمع الذي في قلبي مرض. O wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not like any other woman. You are unique. Aisha, Hafsa, Maymuna, Zainab bint Khuzaymah, Zainab bint Jahsh, our mothers radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. If you keep your duty to Allah, then be not soft in speech, lest he in whose heart is a disease should be moved with desire, but speak in an honorable manner. Subhanallah. They try to attract the women, and also from their side, I mean the side of our sisters, be careful. Speak normally. Don't be soft with the men in your talk. I mean the strangers. Because the shaitan will move their hearts toward you to do the haram wal-iyadu billah. And this speech was to the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best woman at the day of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why they think about the adultery? Because of a disease in the heart. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a hadith. Verily, when the slave of Allah commits a sin, a black spot appears on his heart. When he refrains from it, seeks forgiveness, and repents, his heart is polished clean. This is another hadith than what I mentioned before a few minutes. So there is a chance that we clean our hearts, we protect our hearts. And this is a human being. We do the sins. It doesn't mean that we are angels. We are sinless. We do a lot of sins. كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمْ خَطَّاءُ. The Prophet ﷺ said, all the sons of Adam, خَطَّاءُ. What does it mean, خَطَّاءُ? Doing a lot of sins. Not only once, twice. We are doing a lot of sins. Allah knows our sins. My wife doesn't know my sins. You don't know my sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what we are doing. If you are hiding yourself from the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. Even Allah knows what is inside your heart, what you are planning for. So if you resist, Allah will clean your heart. Allah will make it sound and white. But if he returns, it increases until it covers his entire heart. If you did not resist and you insist to do the sins, and you do the sin after sin, it will be covered by a black color. And that is called الران. كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. الران, it is the cover, the covering surrounding the heart because of the sins. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. And one of the sins, الغل والحسد, the envy, the ill feeling toward the others. والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned one type of the believers who came after the Muhajirin and the Ansar. They say in their dua, O Lord, forgive us and our brothers who have preceded us in faith, and put not in our hearts any hatred against those who have believed. So there is a disease called al-ghil wal-hasad, the envy, the hatred. And we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this disease from our hearts, because this is a very dangerous disease. وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكْ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. And don't obey the one whose heart we have made heedless of our remembrance. don't care about the akhirah. Only their concern is the dunya. Also, one of the diseases can happen to the heart, or the, one of the reasons is the Jum'ah Salah. I mean, missing the Jum'ah. It is weekend. It is off day. Every day I'm working, I have only one off day. Why should I come to the masjid, join the jama'ah? I should take rest or go to a picnic. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, either some people stop neglecting the Friday prayers, or Allah will seal their hearts and they will be among the heedless. This is very dangerous. Missing the Jum'ah Salah can cause a disease in the heart, or it is a sign of one of the heart diseases. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد. How can we treat this disease? It is a serious disease and very dangerous disease. Number one, Quran. Number one, Quran, Kitabullah, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is available everywhere. It is free. You don't need to pay anything. Just read the Quran, understand the Quran, and you will be cured. You will be okay. Ya ayyuhan nas, qad ja'atkum موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. Amen. There has come to you an advice from your Lord and a cure for the disease of your hearts. Quran, the book of Allah. Are we reading the Quran? Yes, we are reading the Quran. Alhamdulillah, every Ramadan we read the Quran. 12 months, only 1 month every year. Every day you are reading the news. And you are not reading the Quran every day. Wallahi, I am busy. Read the Quran. Don't complain if you have a problem. Don't complain if you are not reading the Quran. We need to read the Quran. We need. Read the Quran. How many pages should I read? Read the Quran. Every day 20 pages. Every day 30 pages. Every day 15 pages. It depends. But we have to read the Quran. You memorize or you read from the book. Read the Quran. This is a very strong treatment for the heart diseases. Number two, al-dhikr. Remembering Allah. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. Remembering Allah is greater. Greater than what? Everything. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. The ones who believe and their hearts are peaceful with the remembrance of Allah. Listen, the hearts find peace only in the remembrance of Allah. Many times we complain, I am suffering, I have problem, I don't feel comfortable. There is something. How can I cannot understand what is the problem. You cannot understand, you don't understand. Remember Allah. Say astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. Say dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you pray asr, for example, sit in the masjid, don't go home. Between Maghrib and Isha, or even at home, mention the Kalamullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will find the peace only in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last one, the third and the last, dua. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah, Ya Muqallib al Qulub, Thabbit Qalbi ala Deenik. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say this dua, O changer of the hearts. Make my heart firm upon your religion. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا، ربنا ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمن ومطمئن وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا واجمعنا معهم في الفردوس يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.